저 인사할까요? 아, 저 인사할까요?
네, 저 인사할까요?
아, 예.
So this is the first major function as such which is being held in this resort. It has functioned as a regular holiday resort, but this is the first official function. A brand new conference hall, thanks to sweat, blood and tears of Dr. Zarkale and his team over the past 6-7 days. I think they have put together a fantastic conference hall together.
Let me formally welcome you all here. Chira is a concept, you know, the way we have developed it is very unique. Maharshi Dondo Kesho Karve is born here. So this soil, this land, this air has something which is unique. And they have created some of the India's greatest reforms. Recreate.
So we thought, then we came here to my brother.
Yeah! Who has decided?
Thank you so much. Thank you.
I think lots of opportunities.
It is called ISBA
Convergence.
So it's not a conference, it's a convergence of people of different thoughts, ideas, and this one will be permanently called as ISBA Convergence.
Right. Okay.
Now, volunteers, anybody can go on cutting. Then you can go ahead.
Morning everybody, my name is Vinod Sipka. I am from Sardar Patel Technology Business Incubator, Bombay.
You know, like our focus is to promote, strengthen science and technology entrepreneurship, innovations related entrepreneurship in the country.
This incubation movement, and it's very nice to see that it's actually becoming an industry. Incubation as an industry, and if it's an industry, what are the norms for the industry? That I think if we can put together, it'd be great. We do both virtual incubation and physical incubation.
People dive into a swimming pool and go for a conference. I think there was some cold drink which did this ad, so that's the way we started promoting. Another thing, so right now we've supported physical startups. I think we've crossed 60.
All very rich resources, facilities which comprises of the typical labs, equipment, etc.
I don't have finance background, I don't have commerce background. I'm a wildlife biologist, I have been a trained botanist. I'm a plant taxonomist. I was a professor of botany for 18 years in Pune University in Ferguson College. And then moved on this. When I came 17 years ago as a director of science and technology park, I did not know how to read balance sheet. So I argued with my auditor how can credit and debit or burden your balance sheet. It's how it can say it has to be at least some rupees up or some rupees down. So he said, what is the matter? I'm going to deal with it. So, but now we have interested in complete and a lot of success stories. I'm not going to various stories. But one thing I can tell you very proudly that our team is very dedicated. Our ecosystem is very unique. We have no master in office. Nobody sends masters. Nobody applies for leave. We don't maintain any record. There are no proper office timings.
And where do we think that we should let the startup go free and we do not want to actually engage with them any?
Because as I am personally new to this kind of field, so
I
Myself Vinod Sikka from Sardar Patel Business Technology Incubator from Bombay. This ISPA conference, I feel this is excellent because of location and the way it is being conducted. I feel this is the best way.
Hi, myself Devesh. I am from KIT Technology Business Incubator from the Temple City of Odisha called Bhubaneswar. We are a Section 25 company in which we promote innovation and entrepreneurship. ISPA, I can say it's a complete family of knowledge. That's what ISPA means to me. The great network platform to do something for the society.
We have made effort with government of Maharashtra that this region should be developed like something like a French Riviera. And because this is a land of innovation.
Hi, I'm Pradeep Dage, working for MIT Pune Incubation Center, that is a technology business incubator, started by a visionary person, Dr. Mangesh Karat. I've been working with TBI as an incubation manager since 2 years. ISPA is like a supporting agency for all the technology business incubators. They are helping a lot as far as mentorship, as far as resource making is concerned.
You need to know about management. So you get 50 less money, you get 5% more energy from your operation cost for the water business. They go to the problem, you have this CSR activity, and we are going exactly, you know, social impact in this.
Sustainability has been a serious concern that has been putting us a lot of stress on our management of incubation management. Otherwise, we will always look for some kind of source of funding. Your efficiency, I mean, whatever time that you have, which should actually go for poor incubation business, it's digressed. You do something else because you know that after a few months or a few years, you are not going to sustain. So this is a serious concern that I feel everybody has. We have to be very open, honest and transparent, say that, boss, this is not going to work. You want us to perform, you know, like in this year's financial budget, there's no word of startup. Last year we were very aggressive, startup, and there's no word of startup. This is a very serious concern. Now, I think this is a very serious dialogue, the teams, I would appreciate if you can really voice this.
So, grand challenges, core, non-core, debatable, right? Aligned.
My purpose is to raise funds, and that is my ultimate. How I do it, the process can be market is actually.
Yeah, right, right.
I did? Which one?
Basically,
you know, in automotive.
Less opportunities means what? Less competition. Right? It's a bad thing. If there are less number of people there, there's less competition. By nature of the investment that we are making here in healthcare or health tech, has no comparative risk. That just solves one problem right there and there. To me, that's a great sector to invest. Cut this there, right?
Yeah.
Agtech, food tech. Sorry for the colors here, you were playing around with it. So. The way we look at agtech, you don't care about much about the food delivery export. So we want to look at technologies which can fingerprint, so to say, quote unquote, these producers which can then be price accordingly. So now immediately you get into the pricing platforms, horizontal platforms, you get into the scheduling platforms, you get into all these things.
Against the hay one.
Last 2.5 years in this entrepreneurship, and I'm also a member of OISPA. ISPA really doing very nice things. And you know, Sidam Institute is working in this area since last 6.5 decades in the area of science and technology area. We had developed lot of technology, and before this incubation services or incubators related issues are started in the country, we are already providing services in the country. ISPA is really a association where the people can join hands, and this ecosystem can exponentially converted the whole country in terms of the manufacturing sector, in terms of the IT sectors. The things can multiply by maybe 10-fold, maybe 100-fold, maybe 1,000-fold.
I'm Dr. Nachiket Thakur. I belong to STP Pune. I take care of the entrepreneurship development and innovation at STP Pune. There's a lot of collaboration activities. People come together, interact, do a lot of networking, and it gives a high stimulus to whatever we are trying to do at India for innovation. There's a lot of buzz. A lot of people are joining the bandwagon, and there's a lot of support from corporate as well as the industry and the government. So I hope this will give good stimulus to the entire growth of the ecosystem.
Jump in like a dolphin.
Hey!
ISPA!
For the GST, we will try and wrap it up in about 20 to 25 minutes, and then probably have about half an hour, 45 minutes on the innovation ecosystem development, followed by lunch.
Government approved incubator centers had some kind of service tax exemption, which was extended to incubators as well as to their incubatees. The deal was that incubators don't pay service tax at all. Incubatees for 3 years, first 3 years, up to 50 lakhs of their revenue, they were exempt for service tax.
Where you will have to indicate incubators turnover growth. Right? There has been recently a meeting with the Service Tax Commissioner and DST and the Finance Ministry. We are prompting you to say that you have 5 years return. Even here.
All of you did know about it and posted on his group. What is the status?
Is it clear? I mean, or anybody has any questions? Or suggestions as to, so one is Dr. Devgar has suggested that we make a representation. Does anybody else have any right to that?
We have to submit for the first thing, the incubator has to submit it.
So what you have to do is you have to place a request to DST.
So whatever revenue we have, based on that, we have to pay.
Then, and grant support or recommendation on the GST bill. So that impacts on every service that you offer.
For us, yes, as incubators.
It would be good to debate on the groups. I will give you one example. This GST was one thing.
Thought of this blanket business, but then when we ATG, there are also other challenges.
This is not a normal resort. I do not really notice this, and it's not so easy also to notice. Almost 80% of the power that we have here is a solar. Backside we have a solar power plant, and this 100% water is recycled. Not even one drop of untreated sewage goes outside campus. All the entire water which is in the taps, you know, even in the washrooms, is drinkable. It's a treated water. We have a full-fledged treatment plant here, and everything is treated. With the product developed by one of our associated company, a technology licensed from National Chemical Laboratory. It's a US membrane-based technology. The full-fledged treatment plant is here. If you see here on the campus, all the timber that is used and the memorial terracotta tiles that we have, they are all recycled tiles. That means people in coastal Maharashtra, they have been demolishing their houses and going for cement concrete buildings. We go to each and every village to see who has demolished houses. This timber, which is mainly what is called aisle, is one of the terminal species which is used common timber for construction, which is very hard and the carpenters refuse to work many times. So it could be about few hundred year old timber which is lying waste. And so we salvage that, go to villages and buy that with the tiles. So all the cottages have been built using the recycled timber as this. So some of the timber could be 500 year old also. So there is no cement concrete used for construction. And it's called Chirai, because the red shoe that we have around is called Chirai in local language. So all the paint that you see outside, reddish paint, it is nothing but Chirai powder, no synthetic paint. So that's what is used for painting. We added one polymer to fix it, and so that's what you see.
Hi, I'm Vijay Nadimenti, Chief Operating Officer of AIDEA, the Technology Business Incubator of ICR NARM, the National Academy of Agricultural Research Management at Hyderabad. We are an agriculture-focused incubator, and primarily what we do is we support agriculture entrepreneurs at various levels. We run sensitization ideation workshops of very early stage student entrepreneurs. We run incubation program for early stage startups. We run food and agribusiness accelerators for startups aspiring to scale up, and we also make seed investments in a couple of startups which are trying to scale up and investment ready. ISBA to me is a nodal agency which handholds all the incubators in the Indian ecosystem. It is a major word of mouth for all the incubators' concerns, for streamlining all the process of incubators and creating a good benchmarks and good incubator practices in the ecosystem. It has been a major agency to anchor all the incubators, set up an interface within all the incubators, and be an advocacy and policy support body to DST and the other incubator supporting agencies.
Hello, I am Jnana Samandam. I am the business manager of the technology business incubator of the Tamil Nadu Agriculture University, Coimbatore. So this incubator is functioning from the year 2011. So we are an agri business incubator and one of the largest agri business incubator in the country. And as of such, today we are having about more than 175 startups enrolled into our business incubator, and we are supporting ventures on almost all aspects of agriculture. See, ISBA is a kind of organization wherein it is involved in the networking of all business incubators. And since we are an old member of the ISBA, and since then we are getting the support of ISBA, the networking support with all other incubators, and this is going to be a very good chance to meet all other incubators here. And so we are in constant touch with ISBA also for all other events, and we'll always coordinate with ISBA. And I thank ISBA for giving us an opportunity to be here today.
I am Preeti, manager of the Technology Business Incubator of National Institute of Technology, Calicut. This incubator has been there for the past 13 years, started in 2004, and I've been managing it from its inception onwards. I'm basically an architect. Started my incubation career along with this starting of this incubation center itself. ISBA actually has been handholding incubators like us for this long years, like for the past 12 years. So it has been giving a lot of support for all sorts of problems that we face, and even dealing with the ministries and helping making policy decisions and all. It's been very supportive.
I'm Prachi Singhal from Zone Startups. Zone Startups is an international accelerator working with tech startups to help them scale up. We came into India around 3 years back and have a joint venture with Bombay Stock Exchange currently in Mumbai. We also run two other accelerators in India, one with Barclays and one with Axis Bank, both are fintech accelerators. Other than this, we run two initiatives, one for women entrepreneurs building tech startups and one for high-tech startups from India who have a potential for North American market. ISBA. ISBA is incubator for incubators, wherein we learn from our peers and act as a learning and sharing platform for us.
This is Manpreet, and we run a private equity fund back in the US. It's called Blue Sky, but we are starting with 37 North fund. It's 37.37 because it's the latitude of Silicon Valley where the idea was conceived. We want to bring our operating past experience to India to help the Indian startups or the Indian innovation ecosystem to grow. Our fund is focused on investing in innovation-driven startups in health tech, clean tech, and ag tech, food tech, and a few horizontal platforms which we think have a validity across the world, so they are globally scalable, they are secular global problems. We think that India has significant potential that we can tap into and generally help the world. Yeah, I think it's been a fantastic conference, honestly. When we came in, we did not know what to expect. And I think to judge a conference, you got to see the quality of questions which are being asked at the conference. That will tell you what kind of conference it is. And what we heard over the last 2 days is the quality of the questions from everybody was just fantastic. Very practical, very probing questions. And that's what we want to look for to define a successful, good, quality conference. And then we thought that ISBA was right up there, I would say, in the 99.9 percentile category of the conferences that I have attended in the past. So very, very happy to be here.
For me,
Street. So Snack and Street are... Snack has a free version, free or lower price version, which allows us certain things. The pain in the low price version or the free version is that it doesn't keep history for long. It's a project management tool or pipeline. So it can be used for various purposes, right?
For less.
Wow.
Wow. Really nice. Like you can't create questions based on previous question kind of things.
I've done my past business in transport sector. About to be bought by Ola, but it didn't happen. Unfortunately, I failed. Then I moved on to Indian Engine Network. This is my second phase.
As you, when you go back, you must carry some beautiful memories. Of course, you will have beautiful memories of staying here. Beautiful Warwick paintings. These are original paintings by Warwick. And as a memory.
Each one is hand-drawn.
And each one is hand-drawn. They are not photocopied. They are hand-drawn.
Careful. You want to take another one?
Huh, this is another one.
Yeah, yeah. Give that back.
Huh,
I'll
take it.
No, I'm not going to.
Definitely no kisses. How guy might consider. Yeah.
Nice. Everyone get your hand on roll out.